Good afternoon, everybody, and greeting from IKRI Hospital, Noida. I have no financial interest attached to this presentation.
To the mic.
Good afternoon, everybody. Greetings from IKRI Hospital, Noida, and I have no financial interests attached. My presentation will be basically a thought process of a resident, how he learns SICS and how he thinks while doing a case of SICS, because ultimate goal of a resident is to learn FACO and convert to FACO and start doing independent cases. So SICS, now a basic qualification for a cataract surgeon, is a wonderful technique and has been extremely helpful for us as we strive to convert to FACO. A whole lot of complications can be prevented if the trainee first learns SICS and then FACO. As we know, two countries reside in India. In India, the problem of affordability cannot be ignored, and SICS helps in training new ophthalmologists in the art of FACO at no extra cost. At our institute, we have observed that those surgeons who are well versed with SICS can convert to FACO easily and rapidly, and trainees already doing SICS need lesser number of cases to complete the steps of FACO and graduate to independent surgeries. In the past, surgeons used to learn FACO after ECC, rendering this learning curve steeper and longer. The SICS is closer to FACO in many ways, as just explained by Dr. Sahu sir also. I'll just stress upon the steps of SICS and compare it with FACO in my forthcoming slides. Now, making a self-sealing incision is goal of both the surgeries, and one can easily master a self-sealing tunnel as large as 6.5 millimeters, and in our cases which we as residents are doing, we also make even up to 8 to 9 millimeters of tunnels in SICS. Fashioning a 3.2 millimeters clear corneal tunnel in FACO is very easy for him, and a clear corneal tunnel is even simpler in later stages. Side ports are required in both the techniques, so no additional training is required in this step. Maneuvering through the side port with a chopper or a dialer with the left hand can become a habit during SICS. As I am a lefty, I have already started using my right hand to make it going while I convert to FACO, and I have started using my right hand in my SICS cases also. Capsular access is must for a successful completion of FACO, while SICS can be done by any of the techniques, can opener, envelope or capsular access. I have learned capsular access while doing SICS without the fear of complicating a case, because even if one fails in making a good capsular access during SICS, completion of a sutureless surgery is possible, which is the ultimate goal. Thus, there is no initial tension of learning capsular access when one is contemplating to FACO. Both hydrodissection and hydrodelineation are practiced in SICS in routine, so the SICS surgeon can be a master of the hydro procedures also. In addition, I practice learning the rotation of nucleus during SICS, thus the complications of learning this step during FACO shall also be non-existent. Now, the most important step is the nucleus delivery, and this is the only step which is different in the two techniques. If trained in SICS, before attempting FACO, one knows how to respect the corneal endothelium and zonules before handling of the nucleus. If a surgeon fails in FACO, he can easily deal with the situation by converting into SICS. So during the training of FACO proper, SICS trained surgeons need to be trained only in nucleotomy techniques. Coming on to the cortical aspiration, we have been using Simcoe's cannula for irrigation and aspiration for the manual procedure, and during the procedure of SICS, to get a feel of this technique is very essential, and we can always use a bimanual irrigation aspiration with the FACO machine in SICS, making two side ports at the desired sites of the limbus. One can easily master implanting an IOL in the bag in SICS. To start with a rigid IOL and then trained for implanting a foldable aisle in the bag in SICS. This way, implanting a foldable aisle in FACO becomes a tension-free procedure. To sum up, in my training for FACO, the following steps, that is incision, capsulorhexis, hydro procedures, aisle implantation, irrigation, aspiration, have already been learned in SICS. And if the trainee is successful in previous steps, nucleus management is attempted by FACO in cases planned for SICS. In case of problem, he continues with SICS, that is the manual delivery of the nucleus. During this period, we have trained ourselves with automated irrigation aspiration, implantation of foldable IL, if the capsulorhexis is intact, and if the capsulorhexis is not intact, we proceed with a rigid IL in the sulcus or in the bag. A case of complete FACO is given to the trainees when the trainee is successful in all the above steps. The fact is, if the trainee first learns SICS and then FACO, several complications can be prevented, as the only difference between the two techniques is the method of delivery of the nucleus. The biggest advantage of this method of training is that the confidence level of the trainee remains high and the conversion is much faster. Thank you very much and have a wonderful evening ahead.